thousands of acres of prairie and ponderosa pine, abundant wildlife, and the largest maize cave in the world. All this beauty is part of one of the nation's oldest national parks, Wind Cave, celebrating its centennial this year. The cave boasts unique and beautiful formations and the world's best collection of boxwork. The above-ground park offers panoramic views of sweeping prairies where the bison and pronghorn roam and prairie dogs stand guard. In 1890, 17-year-old Alvin McDonald became the first serious explorer of Wind Cave. His diary recounts many of his caving adventures, including discovering vast rooms and miles of underground passages. More than one modern-day explorer has squeezed through a tight passageway, believing they were the first person into a room, only to discover a century-old Alvin McDonald signature waiting to greet them. In the decades since Alvin first began exploring the vastness of Wind Cave, cavers from around the world have crawled, climbed, and squeezed their way into over 107 miles of passages. Explorers have discovered underground lakes, visited frosted lands, found a huge borehole passage over half a mile long, and come upon bizarre formations such as these helictite bushes and dogtooth spar crystals. An exploration into the darkness here is like crawling through the insides of a sponge. Passages lead in many directions, and it is very easy to become lost. These passages formed when water slowly dissolved limestone rock to form void spaces, then drained away. The lighted trail is like a highway running through a deep and dark forest. Walking along the cave's tour route with its close walls and low ceilings is an intimate experience. The stereotypical cave formations, such as stalactites and stalagmites, are rarely seen here. Seen more frequently are formations of popcorn and frostwork made from aragonite. Some rooms appear to have been hit by an ice storm. Perhaps the strangest and rarest formation in Wind Cave is the boxwork covering the walls and ceilings in many parts of the cave. Boxwork, made of calcite, filled cracks in the limestone, and later the limestone slowly dissolved away. It is like a brick wall after the bricks eroded. Above this beautiful underground wilderness lies rolling hills with a beauty all their own. This grassland is one of the last slices of what was once called the Great American Desert, a vast landscape that posed a barrier to early pioneers. Strolling along one of the 30 miles of trails in Wind Cave National Park reveals a world full of color, sounds, and life. A world that provides an easy retreat from civilization. Camping in the park's backcountry is one of the Black Hills' best-kept secrets. It is possible to spend the night camping amidst the stars and sounds of yesterday and wake up with a herd of bison grazing nearby. To the American Indian, these plains were anything but a desert. They contained all that was necessary to sustain life, primarily the huge herds of bison. Wind Cave is a sacred place for American Indians, and it is considered the site of origin for the Lakota people. No visit to Wind Cave is complete without finding out what creates the wind that gives the cave its name. The wind coming out of the entrance is caused by changes in barometric pressure. Nice weather, characterized by high pressure, forces air to blow into the cave. Low pressure, usually indicative of poor weather, forces the cave to breathe out. Winds at the walk-in entrance have been measured at over 70 miles per hour. The nearby town of Hot Springs is blessed with naturally warm, 87 degree Fahrenheit water. Flowing out of numerous springs in the valley, these waters first attracted American Indians, and later European settlers, because of the healing properties the waters were thought to have. The first bathhouse was built shortly after the town was incorporated in 1881. Visitors to Hot Springs bathhouses, such as Evans Plunge, often took an excursion by stagecoach to Wind Cave. using candles for lights, they descended into the bowels of Custer County. This steady stream of visitors helped promote Wind Cave and eventually led to the establishment of the seventh oldest national park. Today, visitors to Hot Springs can still enjoy the healing waters at the town's remaining bathhouses, which are enjoying a renaissance. Nearby attractions include Mount Rushmore, Crazy Horse Memorial, Badlands National Park, the Mammoth Site, Evans Plunge, and Custer State Park. The Black Hills are a land of unusual variety and beauty, as well as fascinating history. Wind Cave, with its wilderness splendor, both above ground and below, is a unique treasure in a beautiful area.